Hello. So I'm continuing to tinker here. I put the keyboard in. Shield is out. And it seems to be firing up okay. I don't see any more strange things happening. I'm just going to touch some of the chips. See if I feel like anything is hot. The other thing, of course, is, you know, with some of these machines, they might need, as they say, to be recapped. What does that mean? Well, I'm assuming some of the larger capacitors might need to be replaced in some machines. They might. Well, I'm going to try this a little differently. I am going to put this little thing on. It's funny, I don't remember it being on all of the machines, so maybe there's a reason for that. Sure, I'm just going to put it there. It's nice, it's secure, it's happy. See what happens. Okay. It's coming up. I do not feel any excessive heat issues. I suppose one thing I could do, or try, is to put the shield back on, but not attach it at those two places. Let's see here. Here's another shield. Are they different? Probably somewhere. Oh, there's a part number 3, 1, 2. Ooh. Okay, I see it now. Anyway. See, on the 128 and other machines, the shield has fingers that go down and help dissipate heat from the chips. This is not one of those cases. So you know what? I'm not going to put it in there. Oh, I am going to put the other screws that fasten the board. And you know, there's one thing here that does sort of puzzle me. This little plastic weenie. It's supposed to be on the outside of the board, holding it in place, and it's not. It could be putting pressure upon it. Well, that didn't do anything. The disc out. Turn it back on. See if it asks for workbench. And it does. Okay. So third stop. I can tell you, everything takes longer. Okay. So, keyboard. It's in location. We'll turn it on. We see a flashing light. What is this? A reset. See a flashing light. Man. I think this machine is destined not to go anywhere. Let's try again. We see a flashing light. What did we do? Lift the keyboard up. It's all good. Alright. This is weird. What's going on here? What is happening? Perhaps it has something to do with this little cookie thing. I cannot imagine. But who knows? Okay, the little cuppy thing is now over the circuit board. Oops. Wrong screwdriver. Alright. Put the screws in. Slide it into position, just so. Turn it on. Comes up, that's workbench. Okay, I reset it, and that's for workbench. I reset it. It asks for workbench. I'll give it workbench. This is strange. Anyway, right now, everything is secure. The only thing that remains sort of undealt with right at this instant are the little fingers that should be holding the shield. I did not bend them back down, so I guess I better do that. Maybe that shield thing was the same problem. Maybe it was that little clip. Maybe that's why they left it off. Anyway, before I do anything else, which might be deemed foolish, I'm going to bend that has, it is old of course, has one of those plastic covers. Reset thing, and that's for the disk. Oh my god. Okay, let's see what is up. This keyboard thing here, oh, it's a little squirrely. It should. They were made to flip around. Just the edge. Maybe also, there's a screw here that maybe just needs to be loosened so I can get it nice and flat in its perfect ultimate position. And then tighten down just a little bit. Alright, so now, the keyboard, is in, turn it on, and we have an error light, 'cause. At least it's more consistent now. Is it the tape? I am not amused. Well, let's Google. Amiga 500 flash. Codes. Hello, Sheldon. Not now, Sheldon. Alright, Amiga 5 link codes. Hello. I know. Sheldon, I just... this is a question thing. That's not, I just want a list. Amiga. I thought we'd show them. Well, this is crazy. It says it's got like 1, 2, 3, or 4, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, it's 10. All right, well, kind of like tinkering around with the pet, and things were not going well. This is not fun. I should have, I'm gonna loosen off this screw a bit. I should have. Loosen off that screw a bit. What are we got here? Sheldon, just give me a moment. So well. So I do know that this has now at the moment the original kickstart 1.2. Which, who knows? I just have a hunch. Which probably means I'm wrong. Hang in there, Sheldon. Hang in there, Sheldon. Alright, kickstart 1.3. On board. Alright. I'm gonna screw these chips or screws back in. I'm gonna turn it back on. 1.3. I'm going to put the keyboard in its place. Keyboard thing does. This plastic shield does like to slip around a little bit. Okay, keyboard in place. Okay, I'm gonna put the disc in. needless to say, I'm mighty suspicious of this, so I'm going to throw it in the bin with the chips that I'm mighty suspicious of. So, well, I'll certainly, I mean, I don't feel bad about this not having a 1.2, because, I mean, it wasn't around all that long, and it was quickly changed and updated to 1.3, and for a reason, I suppose. So. Alright, things are looking a little better. What am I doing? I suppose now I gotta put the lid on. Stay tuned. Thanks for staying with me through this agony.